Lord, I want to be a Christian in my heart, in my heart, in my heart. Lord, I want to be a Christian in my heart, in my heart, in my heart. Lord, I want to be a Christian in my heart. Lord, I want to love to love everybody in my heart. Lord, I want to be like Jesus in my heart, in my heart. Oh, it's in my to be like Jesus in my heart. Amen. Praise the Lord God. Amen. Amen. Welcome to the True Vine Community Non-Denominational Church of Gonzales, Texas, where Jesus Christ is the head of this church, and I am the under-shepherd. I'm Pastor M.L. Calvin. Grace, mercy, peace, love, joy, happiness, all them good things be unto you from God the Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. Remember, this is the day that God has made, and we're going to continue to rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome to another Kicking It with Pastor Calvin. This is the last Kicking It with Pastor Calvin of this old year, and we decide that we're going to do it today. Amen. Excuse me for the way I'm dressed. I just got through jogging my 2 miles, and I didn't want to go home and change, so you'll have to excuse the way I'm dressed. That, by me being dressed like this, shouldn't have anything to do with the Word of God. Amen. You got to hear with your ears and see with your eyes. Amen. Praise be unto God. But nevertheless, I want to thank Elder Brazil, my close friend and my associate, that's been working with me hard down through the years. We just thank God for him, and he's going to keep it with me, and we do have a beautiful passage of scripture we're going to talk about. Amen. I also want to thank the cameraman, Brother Fred, that is out with us this morning. We thank him, too, for his hard work and his dedication unto the Lord.
Yes.
First, amen. As I was stated, we're getting ready to close out this old year, and this year here has been a trying year for me, and not only for me, but those that love the Lord. Amen. I know you've been through trials. I know you've been through tribulation. I know you've been up, you've been down. I know you've been leveled to the ground. But you know, in spite of all of that, you know God is going to see you through your trials and your tribulation. Amen. The Apostle Paul said that there has no temptation that's overtaken us, but such is common unto man. But God is faithful, who will not tempt us above that we are able, but with the same temptation will make a way of an escape that we may be able to bear whatever that confronts us. Now, we're going to get ready to go into our passage of scripture. As I was stating, it's a beautiful passage of scripture. Amen. And we're going to read, amen, St. John's chapter 10, amen, and verses 1 through verses 10. We're going to read that, amen, and we're going to ask Elder Brazil, if he'd be so kind, that he would read that for us, chapter 10, verses 1, and we'll stop at verse 10. Then I will come back and open us up with a word of prayer, and we'll discuss the Word of God, because there's something in here that, amen, God wants
you to know, and as well as he wants us to know. Amen. It's a blessing in it. But you gotta hear it and you gotta believe it. Amen. Amen. Go ahead, Elder.
Read the scripture?
Yes, sir.
Very, very, I say unto you, he that enters not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, mm-hmm. the same is a thief and robber. Mm-hmm. But he that enters in by the door is a shepherd of the sheep.
Yeah.
To him the porter openeth, and the sheep hears his voice.
Yes.
And he calleth him, now calleth his own sheep by name, and leadeth them out. Mm. And when he putteth forth his own sheep,
yeah.
he goeth before them, and the sheep follows him, for they know his voice.
They know his voice. Amen.
And a stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him, for they know not the voice of a stranger.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
Go on.
I'll pick up at verse 6 for you. This parable spoke Jesus unto them, but they understood not what things they were which he spoke unto them. Then said Jesus unto them again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All that ever come before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. Verse 9, I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. Verse 10, and finally, the thief cometh not, but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. Heavenly Father, thank you this morning once again for what our eyes have seen and what our ears have heard and what our hearts have felt thus far. Now we're asking the good Master that you would come in and be in our midst. And let us feel the visitation of your Holy Spirit this morning. Let us feel your love power this morning. Lord, whatever is hidden deep within our soul this morning and within our spirit, pull it out this morning that somebody might hear and believe and come running, Lord, what must I do to be saved? For the word of God is quick and it is powerful and it is sharper than any two-edged sword. Now bless this kicking session with Pastor Calvin. Hope and pray that something be said that might help somebody in the days to come. Amen. And the key verse this morning, I'll read it again. Thank you, Elder Brazil, for helping me read the passage of Scripture. And the key verse, again, if you listen so kindly to what Jesus is saying, the thief come not, mm-hmm. but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. Mm-hmm. Oh, Lord, have mercy. The thief come not but to corrupt things and to overthrow things and to bring about a whole lot of confusion. Mm-hmm. And I stopped by to tell us this morning, I'm so glad that Jesus, Elder, gave us a way out.
Yes.
Amen. And the way out is through him. And that's what the passage of Scripture is going to talk about and tell us, that it's no other way that we can get to heaven but through Jesus Christ. I don't care what the Bible scholars say. I don't care what the best of the theologians say. I don't care what other pastors say. The Word of God says, if you come up in any other way besides coming through the door, you are a thief and a robber.
A robber.
Amen. There's no other way but by Jesus. Isn't that right?
No other way.
He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man can get to my Father but by me.
Amen.
Amen. Okay. And we're going to read verse 1. Amen. And we're going to discuss it, Elder. And I want your insight and I want your input on the Word of God. Because you told me on the way coming over here, you've been preaching ever since 1972, I believe. 73, amen, excuse me. But ever since 1973. And you should be well established in the Scriptures. Amen. Because I was called in 1986. So that lets me know that you have more insight. You should have more insight on the Word of God than I do. Because I know sometimes, amen, I get frustrated and get confused and don't know which way to go sometimes. And I always come to you and try to see if I could pick your brains and maybe you could help me. And you do, because you always send me to the Word of God. And that's the only thing that's going to bring us through is the Word of God. Let me read verses 1, amen, chapter 10, and let's see what this says here. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that cometh not by the door into the sheepfold, but cometh up some other way, the same as a thief and a robber. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Good grace almighty. I don't think the Lord is calling somebody a thief or a robber, but what he's letting us know, if you don't come in the door the right way, amen, you ain't right.
That's right.
Amen. See, you ain't right. You can't sneak in through the back door.
No.
Amen.
No.
Amen. This ain't no back door business.
No.
Amen. This is a front door business.
Amen.
Amen. And I do believe in my heart of heart, if you want to make it to where you need to go, then you need to come through the front door.
Amen.
And not only that, but when you get to the front door, knock on it and make sure you at the right door.
Amen.
And you knock on the door of your heart. And Jesus said, when you do that, I will come in what? He will sup with you.
Right.
So what is that saying, Elder? And verily, verily being said, truly, truly, I say unto you, he that cometh not by the door unto the sheepfold, but cometh up some other way, the same as a thief and a robber. Now you can hear my input. Now what's your input on verse 1?
Well, verse 1 is telling us, man, that if we don't come up, let's say, without letting Jesus be there, the number one.
Number one. Amen.
And without letting Jesus be it, well, then we're coming up as a thief. Because the only door is Jesus.
The only door is Jesus.
See? And it was saying that now he said he came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many received him, they could come on in.
Amen.
I'm saying my way.
Well, you said it a good way.
Yeah.
Amen.
They can come on in.
Amen.
But those that don't receive him
as
a Savior, Lord, and receive him as of what they really need in life, you know.
Well, let me ask you a question, Elder. How do you receive the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior? What are the steps that you have to go through?
Well, to go through to receive him as your Savior, Lord, first you got to hear, when you hear the word and know that there's no other one and no other way to enter and no other way that you can make it in without receiving him as your Savior and Lord. Mm-hmm. I'm saying this, receiving him as your Lord, all that, without asking him to come on in you.
Yeah, come on in. Come into your heart.
Well, where can him in?
Yeah, where can him
into your life. You work him in that.
Mm-hmm.
See, because and the word is said that when was I with Nicodemus.
Yeah.
See, he was, man, he was doing good things he was doing.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was doing bad things.
Uh-huh.
But he said, you must be born again.
But must be born again.
That's letting him in.
Amen. Amen.
Being born again, letting Jesus come into your life to be your Savior, be your Lord. And receiving him as you know he can do it. It's done.
It's done.
Believing in him.
Right.
And trusting in him.
Yes.
Believing he can do it.
Uh-huh.
Now we can come, I'm not saying nothing against, but some may come and receive and accept and don't believe he can do it.
Well,
I'm saying backwards.
Well,
but may not believe in Jesus. May not believe in the one.
Well,
but see, that counts you out. See, that's another. He's not going another way.
Mm-hmm.
But when they fall, how are they? Believing in Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
And accepting Him as their Savior and as their Lord. And believe when they receive and accept Him as their Savior and Lord, that everything else is going to be all right.
Amen. Now, the Apostle Paul said in Romans chapter 10, let me see if I can find that, because I want to be right in case somebody want to know where the scripture is. And I'm going to go to Romans. I do believe it's Romans chapter 10. Just 1 minute here.
Uh-huh.
Amen. And I want to get this right. Romans chapter 10 and verse 9. And this is coming through the door. Amen. This all has to do with coming to the door.
That's right.
And Jesus Christ is the door.
That's right.
Amen. He's the key to eternal life. He's the key to your happiness. He's the key to your joy.
Right.
He's the key to everything on planet Earth and in the heavens above that you need to be able to walk this Christian life.
Amen.
And this is the passage of scripture that was read to me. And this is the passage of scripture that I put my salvation on.
Wow.
This is what it says here. And I needed to know this because I didn't know this. Amen. Listen to what it said. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in thine heart that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved.
Amen.
You mean telling me all I had to do was confess Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior.
Personal,
amen.
That's right.
And you mean telling me I got the keys to the kingdom of heaven?
Oh, yeah, what he said.
You mean telling me if I just confess Christ Jesus, in other words, believe that he is, and believe that he died on an old rugged cross, I'm guaranteed eternal life.
Oh, yeah.
You believe that, Elder?
Yeah, I can't believe it. I believe it. Because look at the thief. What he did on that with Jesus.
On the cross?
Yeah.
What did he do?
He got saved right there. I'm saying that.
But he was a convicted criminal.
That I'm talking about. And because he believed on him, right?
Right.
He believed it.
We're still talking about entering into the door. We're still talking about
that same thing.
Same thing.
The same thing.
We have a trade. We have
same thing.
Straight off course.
No, that same thing.
But he was a thief.
Yeah.
And a murderer.
Right.
But yet still,
he believed. That's right.
And got saved.
Right there.
In a time of death.
Hallelujah.
With a convicted criminal was sentenced to death. But some way, somehow, he confessed Christ.
That's right, he did.
On the cross.
Yes, he did.
Amen. And let me tell you something. I don't care where you are. I don't care what you're doing. I don't care what background or nationality you are. But if you, some way, somehow, can confess that Jesus Christ is your personal Lord and Savior, everything else is going to fall in place.
That's right.
Amen. And I'm going to take it a step further. Everybody might not agree with me. The reason why people is going through hell on planet Earth, they have not accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior.
That's right. That.
Amen. He that cometh in by the door, the same shall be saved.
Mm-hmm.
And what?
What about the one that he proved that died or whatever else? But he turned his face to the world and started believing in Jesus. He gave him 15 more years.
Hezekiah. Huh? Amen. Yeah, Hezekiah.
Is that right?
He was
supposed
sick. That's supposed to
been
in it. Amen. He was out on his deathbed.
Yeah.
He was getting ready to die.
That's right.
But he remembered one thing.
That's right.
He said, Lord.
That's right. He confessed.
He confessed.
That's right.
See, oh Lord, have mercy.
Yes, he did.
When you know how to confess Jesus Christ,
that's right.
Ain't nothing impossible for you.
Nothing.
Amen. And what did he do? He turned to the wall.
Yes, he did.
And he talked to God.
Uh-huh.
He said, Lord, remember
uh-huh.
when I walk righteous before you.
That's right. Remember.
Remember. Uh-huh. See, God knows.
Yes, he knew.
God knows everything that we do.
That's right.
They always say your good gotta outweigh your bad. And Hezekiah's good.
Yes, it is.
Outweighed his bad. See, he became a negotiator.
Yes, sir.
with God, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
And what else did he say? And God heard his prayer.
Yes, he did.
And heard his cry.
Yeah, gave him 15.
And gave him 15 more years.
Wow.
Added to his life.
Wow.
Because he walked righteously.
That's right.
Before God.
That's right.
Amen. He wasn't laying there on his deathbed trying to come up some other kind of way.
No other way.
There wasn't no other way.
He was doing right.
He was doing right. He was straightforward, wasn't he?
That's right.
And you got a lot of people that's trying to sneak in and come up some other kind of way. And you can't do that. That's not going to work. Amen. So let me go back to St. John's chapter 10. And we're going to read verse 2 and see what verse 2 says. But he that cometh in by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. Amen. Come in by the door.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Jesus Christ is the door.
Right.
He's the only way to happiness. He's the only way to salvation.
Amen.
If you're sick, well then you got to have a little talk with Jesus.
Jesus.
If you're confused, you got to have a little talk with Jesus. Mm-hmm. Amen. I don't really know how to pray, but when something bothered me and upset me, I just start talking. Mm-hmm. I just start praying.
That's right.
And next thing you know, Elder Brazil, things beginning to start working out.
Amen.
But he that cometh in by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. Verse 3. To him the pasture opens. Amen. At the porter open, I'm sorry. And the sheep hear his voice.
Mm-hmm.
And he calleth his own sheep by name.
By name.
And leadeth him out. Ooh, isn't that something?
Oh, yeah.
Jesus know our names.
Yes, he do.
He know who his people are.
That's right.
Amen. He know, and listen, every hair on our head is numbered.
Number, amen.
Amen. And he knows all about everything.
That's right.
But Elder, I've learned that you have to trust Jesus.
That's right.
Isn't that right?
We must.
Must trust him.
That's right.
What you say?
Yeah, we must trust Jesus because he's the only way, the only door, and you can't hit any other way.
But if you try,
let me say it in this way again, too. And the only one that, I'm going to say my way of saying it, could pay the debt. We owe the debt. Because when the sin come up, or when the wrong come up, it has to have someone to come to be a substitute or something to come in your place to make that wrong what you've done to be right when you receive and accept him.
Mm-hmm.
See? Because he's the one that right. Well, let's go back a little further on this. Look a little further on this.
Mm-hmm.
And we talk about this.
Yes, sir.
Look, in the beginning of this will happen. Let's say it like this.
Take your time.
Joseph was a man along with the lady.
Amen. Mary.
Yeah.
Amen.
See?
Mm-hmm.
But now, I'm saying my way of saying it. If he had been come up to be the daddy, we wouldn't have had no chance.
Right. Amen.
But God come in and he moved upon her.
Amen. The Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Moved up on Mary.
Yeah. And she conceived the son.
Mm-hmm.
And then they named him
Jesus.
Yeah. To be the savior of the world. But look at the good again now, look. He didn't get to be half done now. See, because, see, Mary was just a natural woman.
Yeah, natural woman. Yeah,
see, to make it be where it be flushed with both.
Both. Amen.
See what I mean?
Amen.
So Jesus could come to be our savior.
Amen.
See, our Lord. See?
Amen.
But now, it's been like, what I'm saying, my way of saying that. Probably he's just been just all supernatural.
Uh-huh. Supernatural, right.
Wouldn't been married by born by a lady.
Yeah, wouldn't
be like that.
Through a human birth.
Yeah, wouldn't been like that.
Uh-huh.
But then we probably wouldn't have no chance. Yeah.
And if Joseph would have had anything to do with the birth of Jesus by sexual relationship or contact, well then Jesus' blood would have became contaminated.
That life wouldn't work.
And that would have disqualified him because he cannot be connected with sin through a human birth.
No.
So therefore, Joseph was out of the picture.
That's right, he was.
Amen. And I'm so glad.
That's right.
He didn't have anything to do with the conception of Jesus Christ being born into this world.
That's right.
And you hit on it pretty heavy.
Yeah.
And you so glad that it wasn't supernatural.
No,
because it would have been, if it became supernatural, then that would have put us in another dimension.
That's right.
But it had to have been through a human birth.
That's right.
That we might be able to understand.
That's right.
Amen. What's going on?
That's right.
Amen.
See, it was a lady. Look now. A lady just, I'm saying, natural lady.
Uh-huh.
Whatever.
Amen.
And then when he chose out, I'm saying he chose out.
She was a special lady chosen.
He chose out.
Amen.
To be the birth. Be the mother.
A birth mother.
Yeah.
Amen.
So he did it. So rewind. I'm saying this that way because it has to be both flesh and blood, both.
Amen.
It can't be just he just supernatural all the way.
Yeah.
See, mm-hmm. That'd be both, so it can bring us into this.
You're right, amen.
See,
amen.
So now that means why when we go to Jesus, see,
amen.
Because of what he did,
mm-hmm.
because I'm saying, Mama, now,
mm-hmm.
because of what he did, and the debt that we were paying was all full and perfect and perfect for us, so we could receive it and get it because it was paid for.
It was paid for. And you know, I hear a lot of people talking, and I'm just going to throw this out here, and I hope those that are listening might catch this. Amen. All no disrespect for Mary, not trying to put her down or anything, but I'm so glad that she was chosen by God to do this.
That's right.
Now, she became an incubator. You know what an incubator is? Amen. When a baby gets sick in the hospital and the mother cannot provide for the baby inside of her stomach and womb, well then the baby is taken out and placed in a special machine, which is called an incubator, and keep that baby alive and nourish that baby. Well then, that's what Mary was used for. She, when Jesus was implanted in her stomach, she became the incubator.
That's right.
And to nourish him, to nourish the baby,
right.
and keep the baby alive, and let the baby grow. And when the time comes for her to give birth, then everything's all right. But see, a man's sperm couldn't connect with Mary.
Because
if it would have,
it
would disqualify
her. That's right.
Amen. And then that way, his bloodstream would have been connected with sin.
That's right.
And he cannot have no kind of connection.
No.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
Hallelujah.
With sin. That's why when I read Romans chapter 10 and verse 9, this is what it said. If thou shalt confess with thy mouth
the Lord
Jesus Christ and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved.
That's right.
Something else comes after that.
Uh-huh.
You got to believe that he died and came back to life.
That's right.
Amen.
Now, listen, we talking about it.
Well,
now, look.
Let's talk about it.
Now, look what we talking about now. Look. Now, suppose now.
Uh-huh.
We
still keeping with Pastor Calvin.
We're saying this.
Amen.
That he wouldn't have come back alive. But to put him in grave and everything, he wouldn't have come back alive.
Okay.
But he did.
He did.
And he rose again. Come out of the grave.
Mm-hmm.
Suppose he would have all this, he wouldn't have lived none of this.
Mm-hmm. So he was born to die.
That's right. He was born to do all this.
Lord have mercy. That was his only mission.
That's right. He was born to do all this. And look at how he did. He picked out a woman.
Lord have mercy.
He picked her out.
Well now you can't too much get mad at the Catholics now. You say what they want to say about the Catholics. But they kinda got it in a way, and in a way they don't have it.
Yeah.
They hope they have hollow respect for Mary.
That's right.
And that's good, there's nothing wrong with that. But they shouldn't take her and place her over Jesus.
Oh no,
sometimes they does that.
And
I don't think sometimes they really realize what they are doing. She was specially chosen this task.
That's right.
To bring Jesus into the world.
Yes, she was.
How they say Hail Mary, full of grace, and chosen to be the mother of the Son of God. There's nothing wrong with that, because that is true.
That's true.
Amen. Right. And he came into the world to die.
That's Yes, he did.
For the sins of the world.
That's right.
Amen. I cut it you off and I should have done that. Amen. I hope you still got your thought. What else did you say?
Yeah. And just think about it. Now he was a, see, now look, if it hadn't been, I'm saying my way, a common natural lady, like we would have been, supposed to have been, she'd been supernatural. Like,
supernatural, right.
See it, what I mean?
It wouldn't work.
Wouldn't work.
Right.
See? But it was a lady that, I'm saying he chose that.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
And he counted worthy for this.
Right. Amen.
So, and that was happened.
That's so that Jesus could feel what we feel.
Sure.
And
say it, Pastor.
And to experience what we experience.
Right.
On the human side.
That's right.
Amen. See, he hungered, didn't he?
That's right. Huh? Sure he did.
And he got thirsty, didn't he?
Sure he did, just like me.
That's right. He got mad, didn't he?
Sure, just like me.
And yeah, he got mad. Didn't he get mad? Yeah, he went in there. They was gambling, shooting dice in the church house, and selling doves, and just doing everything in God's house. And he got mad.
Sure he did. That's it.
And a lot of people say Jesus didn't get mad, but yes, he did get mad.
Angry.
And you know what he did? The Bible said that he got some rope, good grace almighty, and he tied that rope together, and he went in there and physically put them out of there.
Run them out.
He run them out.
Yes, he did.
Because he was human.
Yeah, sure.
The human side kicked in well as the spiritual side of it.
Sure, he had both.
Amen. And that's what's wrong, and that's the way we are.
That's right.
We are human and we're spiritual.
That's right.
Amen. That's why he had to come through the human birth to feel that what we feel and to have sorrow that we have sorrow. Like Brother Fred said earlier, you got to experience that sorrow too. Oh, that's part of the human nature.
Sure, we have to.
When he said when your kids hurt, you have that sorrow because things is not right with your kids. Well, I'm glad he brought that up because amen, when we sin and we get in trouble, I'm quite sure it hurts Jesus.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
It hurts Jesus to see us like that. But at the same time, we should have enough Christianity
right.
to continue to keep on going.
That's right.
Oh man, this is a good discussion.
Oh,
keep
good.
It with
this
Pastor Calvin here. Amen.
We're
still in chapter 10. We're at verses 4 now, and we're going backward and forward. Amen. The Lord wants us to pull this out that somebody that might look at this, might understand what we're saying. Let me read verse 4. And when he put forth his own sheep, he goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. Jesus knows who we are.
Oh, yes, he does.
He knows our voice. I said earlier, every hair on our head is numbered, that lets me know that God knows all about us.
Yes, he does.
Amen. And he knows just how much we can take.
He knows just how much we can bear. He knows how much we can take. That's right.
Amen. Amen. Yeah. Amen. But it's only one way.
Only one way.
And that's through the door.
That's right.
Amen.
And Jesus is the door.
He's the door.
That's right.
He's the way. Mm-hmm. He's the truth. And he's the light.
It's somebody says in there that, he said, if any man come unto me, I will in no wise cast him out.
How do I come to Jesus? How do they come to Jesus? How do you come to him?
Come to Jesus.
Wounded? Sad? Confused?
Yeah.
Frustrated?
Right. And bad in mind, knowing that he is the only way.
He's the only way.
For me. See, that's accepting him. All the way.
All the way, not halfway.
No, see, when you go halfway.
This ain't no halfway business.
No.
Either you is.
That's right.
Or you ain't.
That's right.
Amen. And he knows who you are.
Sure he knows. He said he knows.
Those faking and pretending, don't he know who they are?
Sure he knows. He know
just oh, that. Man, my goodness.
Oh, Lord, this is so good.
Yeah, amen. Praise be unto God. Amen.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Brother Fred, how we doing on the camera? We all right?
We can't see it.
Can't see it. Oh, amen. Well, we're going to play it by heart here. We're going to get through this. We don't want to go over an hour.
No.
Amen. So we won't put too much work on him. But anyway, let me read verse 5. Elder, if you will.
Verse 5 says, and a stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him, for they know not the voice of a stranger.
A sheep knows who his leader is.
That's right. And I'm saying this now, like in the natural. If we
want to say, no. I know what you're finna say. Go ahead and say.
No, I'm saying it right.
Go ahead.
And if you go out among a bunch of sheep and things, whatever, and you've not been there before, you just come out there a stranger. They're all gonna run.
They're gonna run. They're gonna flee from you.
They're gonna flee.
See, I'm not a country boy, so
that's right. They're gonna flee.
I'm from the city.
And now the one that sheep killer. One hour at a time, they ain't gonna do that.
So Jesus is our shepherd, isn't he?
That's right.
He's the good shepherd, isn't he?
Good shepherd.
Amen. And we know who he is.
That's right, sure.
At least we're supposed to know who he is.
Yeah.
And he know who we are.
That's right, he know. He's
saying, amen, no. Amen. And when the good shepherd comes, the sheep ain't gonna run.
No, he not.
No, no, they'll run to him.
That's right.
Because they know who he is.
That's right.
But the stranger,
ooh, they gonna flee.
They gonna take off.
And I'm saying, what?
Oh Lord, amen. Praise be unto God.
That's
amen.
But
amen.
Well, that's real.
That's real. Amen. Let me read verse 6. This parable spoke Jesus unto them, but they understood not what things they were which he spoke unto them. They didn't understand.
Mm-hmm.
See, when it's something you don't understand, you need to ask somebody.
That's what I'm understanding.
Yeah, if it's something you don't understand, ask somebody. It's a whole lot of things I don't understand in the ministry. I have to ask somebody.
Mm-hmm.
I have to go to pastors. I have to go to preachers. I have to consult them and ask them which way to go. Amen. I don't know it all. Elder don't know it all.
No.
Amen. He has to come to me sometime. And I have to go to him. And that's the way it works. Because nobody know it all.
No,
I'm going to read it again. This parable, Jesus spoke a parable, amen, unto them. But they understood not what thing they were which he spoke unto them. That's a lot of things I don't know.
That's right.
Amen. And you need to ask somebody.
That's right.
Amen. Which way you should go. And all we are saying this morning is, amen, Jesus is the door.
That's right.
To the shepherd fold.
He's the door.
He's the door. And you cannot come up in no other kind of way.
No other way, it says.
Amen. You try to come in through the window, you're lying.
No other way.
Amen. You come up through the back door.
A thief or a robber.
You're a thief or a robber.
That's what he said.
If you try to go up on top of the house on the roof and cut a hole in and try to come in that way, that ain't gonna work either.
That ain't gonna work.
The only way to come in is through the door.
Through the door.
And that's Jesus Christ.
Jesus is the door.
He's the door.
That's right.
If any man come in and hear my voice, what's gonna happen? He's gonna suck with him. Amen.
That's right.
Praise be unto God. Yeah, read verse 7.
Verse 7 says, then says Jesus unto them again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All that ever came before me are thieves and robbers. But the sheep did not hear them.
Ooh,
see?
It's one thing I don't want nobody calling me is a thief. A thief and a robber.
Yeah.
Amen. What in the world? This is Jesus speaking some pretty strong words here.
Well, he let us know.
He let us know that this is some serious business.
Yeah, they let us know that without him, what we is.
What's here? Without him, that's who we are.
That's right.
We're liars. Thieves.
We're
robbers, but with him, through him,
my,
and when we confess Christ, then all of that is gone away from us, and we become new creatures.
That's right, become new creatures, or become more than a conqueror.
Through Christ Jesus.
Through Christ Jesus.
Who loved us and died for us.
My Lord.
Isn't that something?
They think more than a conqueror.
More.
Ooh, my Lord.
That did the hard part for us.
My Lord.
And that's to die. Why is it so hard for people to comprehend on what this is all about? Mm-hmm. It's all about Jesus. It's all, and you mentioned, I got to go back to the cross. You mentioned about the thief on the cross. He was a thief. Isn't that right?
That's right.
And, but yet, he found a way to get to Jesus.
Uh-huh.
And the way he got to Jesus was he confessed.
That's right. That's what makes you.
That's what makes you a Christian.
That's right.
You gotta confess.
Right.
With your mouth.
Yourself. You got to.
Yeah. You gotta believe in your heart. That's what right. This word is saying.
That's right.
And after all that he said, Jesus told him, "This day."
Oh Lord Jesus.
This day.
Hallelujah.
Not tomorrow.
And not tomorrow.
Not a couple of days from now. Not next month. Right, not right. Next year. But this day. Mm-hmm. In other words, right now, mm-hmm. You shall be with me in paradise.
And that, oh Lord.
Isn't that beautiful?
That is beautiful.
At first he wasn't nothing.
Mm-hmm.
But a thief.
Yeah.
And a murderer.
Uh-huh.
And a robber.
Right.
But he found a way to get to Christ.
Yes, he did.
And the other one was so hateful.
Wouldn't confess.
Wouldn't confess, wouldn't say nothing.
No.
And he died.
That's right.
And went straight to hell. Oh, I'm so glad. Yeah, he went to hell. He went straight to hell.
I guess he did.
Because he did not confess Christ.
Yeah, I know he didn't confess it.
He didn't confess it.
Well, he had to go somewhere.
He died mad.
That's right.
Well, that's what the scripture says. Elder, don't take my word
for
it. Don't feel sorry for it. The truth is the truth. You shall know the truth, and the truth will what?
Make you free.
Will make you free.
That's right.
But I'm so glad that Jesus give us a new way out, and he give us as many chances as it takes to come to him.
That's right.
Amen. You got anything else you want to add?
Well, no more to add, but that it's just letting us know the way that we can make it and to be with him. It's letting us know how we should conduct ourselves, how to come to him,
mm-hmm.
believing and trusting him. And knowing that there's no other way,
mm-hmm.
but he's the only way.
Good Christian, my
God. The only way. Only way.
Yeah.
See, so if we want to make it with him, well, we got to accept that ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, all what we're talking about now, this is a personal thing.
Personal. Personal so, relationship.
Yeah, that's right.
Amen.
See, my mom and dad and nobody, I don't know. We got to
do it for ourselves.
Do it ourselves.
Amen.
And when we do it ourselves, we're going to make it.
Amen.
Because of what Jesus did.
And you know, it's a strange thing. You know, when we was born into this world, we came here alone.
That's right.
And you know something? And when we die out of here, we're going to go alone.
That's right.
Hey, mama's not going to be with us. Daddy's not going to be with us. Nobody is going to be with us when we get ready to die out of here.
Mm-hmm.
What we did on planet Earth, the time that we was here on this Earth, between the time we was born and between the time that we die, we gonna have to answer to all of that.
Mm-hmm.
But yet still, Christ Jesus made it possible through our lifetime that we get it right.
Mm-hmm. You know, I'm looking at this, I could be whatever, but when I look at, in the Bible, it says in Isaiah 53, it says, who has believed our report?
Who has believed our report?
See?
Yeah. This is the report right here. Who has believed that's our
right.
report?
The arms of the Lord is revealed unto them.
Woo-wee. Come on, Elder.
Whoever believes our report.
See, it can be anybody.
That's right.
Any man, woman, that's boy, right. girl got to believe the report.
That's
this
right.
is the report.
Well, that's what it is.
Amen.
What he imminent. What he said they'll do, what he said about it. That way you hear me say sometimes, God is not a man that he should lie.
Well,
neither son that he repent. Has he said, shall not do it. Has he spoken, shall not make it good. If God said it, I said it to people that come out of the if God said it, okay, come and believe it. It's right.
It's right.
But if God ain't said for it and you go trying to fix it up, that's just what we're talking about here.
Mm-hmm. There's no other way you can fix it.
That's right. Ain't no dough for you there.
Ain't no dough there.
And you ain't gonna make it in that way.
This is the only way.
The only way.
The word of God. Yeah. Jesus said it in St. John chapter 14 and round about It's in 14. 14 years, somewhere along in that. Yeah. I am the way, the truth, and the life. You cannot come no other way.
No other way.
But by me.
That's right, Jesus.
And those that don't accept that is eternally lost. Isn't that right?
That's right.
I hate to be so harsh about it, but that's just the way it is. There's no other way.
No other way.
Amen. All this bickering and busting and fighting and all of this, that's just not going to get it.
Not going to get it.
You got to humble yourself.
That's right. Got to be humble.
Got to be humble about it.
Got to be humble.
Amen.
You don't be humble, oh no. Whoa, who that was up there and said, but he got thrown out.
Huh?
He was in there and got thrown out, didn't he?
Got thrown out.
He wasn't humble, was he?
He wasn't humble. Didn't know how to humble himself.
He was in there now.
Yeah.
In there when he wasn't humble. Yeah. Oh, Lord.
Man. You got to be right.
That's right.
You got to humble yourself.
Goodness.
When you go and stand before God, stand before the Lord Jesus Christ, you're going to have that humble spirit.
That's right.
Amen. You can't. Force your way in.
You can't do that.
No. Ooh, good gracious almighty.
Can't do it.
Verse 8, all that ever come before me, Jesus said, are thieves and robbers. But the sheep did not hear them. Mm-hmm. Verse 9, I am the door, Jesus said. By me, if any man enters in, he shall be saved. If any man enter in, if any man come to me, amen, he or she shall be saved.
Amen.
And there's no way I will, what, cast him out.
Uh-huh.
Didn't he say that?
That's what he said. That's
amen.
What he said.
Ooh, good gracious almighty.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Anything else you want to add?
If I get in there, by him, thank you.
Thank you. Got to get in.
Get in by him.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
They ain't gonna get you out no more, huh?
Amen.
You get in there now.
Amen.
By him now.
By him.
I didn't say you. Just get in there.
Can I save you?
Yeah. No.
Can I get you in?
No.
Amen.
You can tell me.
I can tell you how.
And you can be like John was, or John come. He was, he wasn't the one, but he pointed to who?
Jesus.
He pointed to Jesus.
Yeah. He said, look, here comes somebody. Somebody walking over
he
there.
He finds Jesus, didn't
he? Yeah, he's looking up and say, wait a minute. I see somebody coming.
He finds Jesus.
That's the mighty Lamb of God.
He finds Jesus, didn't he?
Coming to take away
the sin of
the sins of the world.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And what else he say? I'm not worthy to stoop down and to tie his shoes.
That's right. But he was always pointing to Jesus.
Always pointing to Jesus.
That's what he did.
And what else did he say? I must decrease.
Uh-huh.
And he must increase. In other words, I got to get out of the way now.
That's right.
The Savior's here.
That's right.
Going to do something I can't do.
That's right.
All I can do is baptize you and try to wash away your sin. Wow. But he's going to come and baptize you with fire.
Ooh, yes,
which is the Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Oh! Good grace to my
Lord. Isn't it good?
Ooh, we're going to have to close this out.
This is
so
good.
He is the way.
Yes, he is.
He is the truth.
And the life.
And the life.
That's right.
Oh, good grace to mighty here. And finally, verse 10, but the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. But I am come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. Mm-hmm. Why did he put the word might in there?
Might.
Yeah, let's look at that word might.
Might mean it's up to us to receive and accept him. As I said, might. We might do that and we might not.
Yeah. In other words, it's a possibility that we hear all of this and there's still a chance that we might not accept it.
That's right.
You just said earlier, who shall believe our report?
That's right.
Didn't you say that?
Well,
there's going to be some that's not going to believe the report.
That's right.
So that's them that might.
That's what he said, might.
Might not.
It might not.
Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord.
It got land there for you.
Yeah.
Mama always said, well, I put some wine over out there in that trough out there for the cow to drink. Now, I can't come there and make that cow drink it. I put it out there so she can drink that wine and stuff. But if she don't drink it, going to be up for it, she going to be thirsty.
So, listen. The report.
Listen. You know what
it's listen. The report is here.
That's right.
And
that's right. It's that.
I don't have no words.
Uh-huh.
You don't have no words.
That's right.
But Jesus has the words.
That's right.
And here it is. They might and they might not.
Might not.
That's it's right. up to each individual.
It's up to us. That's
it's
right.
a personal thing.
That's right.
To accept this report.
That's right.
And to accept Jesus Christ.
That's right. And we don't. Whose fault is it?
It's nobody's fault but our own.
Our own.
To call me a thief is fighting words. To call me a liar is fighting words. To call me this and to call me that and disrespect me and don't call me the everything but the child of God, that's a fight. Yeah, you want to know something? I'm so glad that they call me that. You know why? Because that forces me to pick up the report and believe the report.
Believe it. That's right.
Now see, calling people thieves and robbers, hey man, I ain't no thief, I ain't no robber. Well then, if you're not, you better accept Jesus Christ.
That's going to change
that's it. Gonna change things.
Go on, preach it.
That's going to change it if you accept it.
That's right.
And if you accept that report, but if you don't, you in trouble.
That's right. That's why I think it said, I think it's John, it said, he said, I came unto my own.
Came unto my own.
And my own received me.
They rejected me.
But as many as received.
Yeah.
I gave him that power.
To become
yeah.
the Son of God.
That's it, right?
Ooh, isn't that beautiful?
That's beautiful, man.
Oh, man. I wouldn't take nothing back.
That's all right. Hallelujah.
Ooh-wee.
Whoa, Lord.
Yeah, listen. And it goes to something else. It's something else in verse 10 that the Lord, before we get ready to close it out,
verse we're going
to bring it out. Verse 10. The thief cometh not, but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I come that they might have life. What kind of life?
Huh?
Eternal life.
That's right.
Amen.
And they, okay.
Yeah. And
they
that,
might have, yeah, okay.
And that they might have it more
Amen.
Abundantly.
Mm-hmm.
Woo-wee.
They have it more abundantly. And then I look so
God Almighty.
And we look at, we're not getting away from it, but we look at what in 1 John, where would I say? It says in that.
What is it?
That we can have eternal life. Now see, we talk about this, but we read over there, you see that.
You said it's marked somewhere over there. Where, find out where it's marked at. You said something was marked there. Amen.
Yeah.
You remember where it was?
Yeah.
Give you a second. Amen. Yeah, amen. Just, ooh, isn't it wonderful? The Apostle Paul said, while he's looking for that, the Apostle Paul said, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, it has not entered into the hearts of man what God has prepared for those that love him. And if you love him, it's already prepared for you, but you have to be prepared for that place. Isn't that's that right,
that's
brother?
That's right.
It's already prepared for us.
It's already.
Amen. But we have to prepare ourselves.
That's right.
And the only way that we're going to prepare ourselves is that we're going to have to believe the report and go through the door.
That's right. Believe the report. That's it.
Got to believe the report.
That's right. Got to.
Amen. When I was going to school, every so often, every 2 months, every 3 months, the teacher used to give us a report card.
That's right. Amen. Remember that? The teacher used to give us a report card.
And amen. And we had to take our report card home to our parents
right.
to see just how far we came along in school.
We didn't do good.
Amen. If we didn't do good, then we got D's and we got F's and we got C's. But if we did good, we got what? A's and B's, amen. It's the same thing. Amen. We got to believe the report. Okay. Isn't that right?
Oh, that's right.
You ain't found it yet?
Ask me. No, I'm not looking at it.
Well, read it.
Petition that we desire him. Okay, I'm just going to read this.
All right.
It says, I'm going to start reading this 13th verse.
Okay, go ahead.
It says,
St. John's what? First John.
First John.
Chapter what? Chapter 5?
Chapter 5.
And you're going to start reading that verse 13?
13.
And we're going to get ready to close out after this.
These things, have I written unto you.
Mm-hmm.
That believe on the name of the Son of God.
Mm-hmm.
That you might know, not that you might think.
Well, that go that word right again.
That you might figure.
had to
go. Might.
Might. Had to go again. Come on.
That's what he said.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about now.
Yeah.
That you might know.
That you might know. That you don't know.
That's right.
That you need to know.
That's what you might know.
All right.
That you have eternal life.
Mm-hmm.
And that you may believe on the name of the Son of God.
Oh, man.
Ooh, I tell you, that's so powerful.
But then, did you hear what you said earlier? That they might.
That's what it said.
Believe.
If they don't.
On the name of the only begotten Son of God.
That's right.
He is that door that we were talking about.
That's what the same thing what she's saying.
And if you.
That's bringing the same thing.
Lord, if you get in any other kind of way.
You're a thief.
You're a thief.
And a robber.
And a robber.
Oh, Lord, you know that ain't going to
go. Huh?
You ain't going to go in the way.
That ain't going, you ain't going to heaven like that.
You're the robber.
No. And you really ain't going to go and get along with too many people down here. If you stealing and robbing ain't going on.
Ain't no way.
So you in trouble both ways.
They ain't going to like you.
They're not going to like you, huh?
No.
Amen. Praise be unto God. Praise
be
unto God. Amen. Praise be unto God.
We thank God for His word.
Amen.
Of encouragement to our hearts.
Amen. Amen.
I'm saying this because that everything that we get in the Bible, reading of the Word of God, is encouraging us to read, believe on Him.
Believe on Him.
Trust in Him.
Amen.
And I'm saying this as I'm talking about this. In everything that we're doing, whatever it is, in whatever it is, maybe I'm wrong.
No, you ain't.
But it got to be a little bit of encouragement.
A little bit of encouragement.
And God got something that He does to us as an enemy, whether we accept it or believe in it, whatever, to encourage us to go on that way.
Yes, sir.
He encourages us to go on. We may say, oh, no, yes, He do. He got something to happen, something coming. And we may not know what it is, may not pay attention to it, but He gives it to you to encourage you to go on with Him.
Mm-hmm. If we didn't have the Word,
that's
if we didn't have the report,
that's right.
Where would we be? What would we do?
Couldn't make it.
Couldn't make it.
You wouldn't even know which way to go.
And sometimes, Elder Brazil, the Word of God is a little harsh. And sometimes, and sometimes the Word of God is a hard pill to swallow sometimes.
That's right.
Because if you're not where you're supposed to be, and sometimes you feel like the Word of God is picking on you.
That's right.
But it's not picking on you.
No,
it's only trying to make you stronger.
That's right. And we read it, it's over, and I think Matthew, I don't forget about that. It says in that, that He chastened them that He loved.
He chastises those that He loved.
Now see, chastening means everything will be going just like with you. Chastening means there's something funny around with you.
Mm-hmm.
Something happening that is hitting on you.
Amen.
Understand?
Yeah.
He's chastening them to see, to see what you're really going
to
do.
To see if you really,
mean to go with Him or not. Uh-huh. Now look, I'm saying it, I could be wrong. If everything went just like you wanted all the time, you would never want to be looking for the Lord. what you gonna need for?
What you need the Lord for?
Right. But when they start going bump a little whatever, and if you got common sense,
uh-huh.
You know what?
Yeah.
You would say, I'm gonna go to the Lord. I'm gonna let the Lord do that for me.
So I hear what you're saying.
Ain't that right?
We get ready to close it out because we're running out of time.
That's right.
If you have everything you wanted on planet Earth, in the world do you need to go through the door for?
You ain't gonna be what you gonna
do. You ain't gonna go through the door.
What you gonna go there for?
You ain't gonna accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior.
You
got it. Why? Because you got everything you want.
Right.
Oh Lord have mercy. This is beautiful. This is good.
Yeah,
this is great.
It is good.
Amen. And Elder, I just want to thank you, amen, for kicking it with me. And I want to thank those that's going to tune in on the website or what have you, that the only way you're going to be able to make it is through Jesus Christ.
No other way.
There's no other way. I mean, man can say what they want to say. They can fix it and twist it however they want to fix it and twist it. The bottom line is this. If thou shalt confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus Christ from the dead, thou shalt be saved. That's
Amen.
It. No other way.
No other way.
Amen. God bless you and God, Elder. God bless you. Thank you for kicking it with me. God bless you and your wife and your grandchildren and all that.
I
hope you had a good Christmas. You know what? I didn't get by to even say Merry Christmas. You know what? I had to work and do all those good things, but I'm looking at you. I know that God has taken care of you. And thank the cameraman, amen. He's here with us. He's
on his post,
amen. Doing his job.
And, he's on his job. Amen.
We're finna get ready and sign off. God love you. So do I. So do we. Go in peace and be blessed of God. God bless you. Next year, Happy New Year. Bye-bye.
Happy New Year.
All right.